One goal for our work is to ensure that all the measures and all the actions we take actually have a lasting effect.
Yung problema sa trading ng mercury ay napakalaking bagay. Hanggat may nagbibenta, merong bibili.
The Philippine situation is similar to a lot of other countries. A lot of the mercury coming in is from illegal imports.
We also have to recognize some challenges like enforcement of the national regulations, where one example is that skin lightening products that contain mercury that continues to be available on the market.
Illegal mercury comes in the form of elemental mercury and mercury-added products such as skin lightening cosmetics that contain mercury. Be it in selling mercury to miners in pawn shops, hardware stores, and dental institutions. Even in skin lightening products found in local markets. Women are predominantly exposed indirectly or directly to mercury fumes.
Luto ng ginto ay sa ilalim kami ng aming bahay nagluluto. Hindi namin alam na yung asoge ay nasa hangin, ay nalalanghap na ng aking mga anak at kapatid. Yung spits niya nasira, yung kamay niya, deformed yung ganito, paa niya nung nakaganon. Yun na yung nakita kong effect ng mercury sa kanya. Yung anak ko ay namatay in 2005. Kaya nga ang advocacy ko ngayon ay ang mercury free na mining.
It has been really revealing to visit several sites here in North Philippines for artisanal small-scale gold mining and talk to the miners and indigenous people's communities. And one takeaway for me is how important it is to have appropriate national, provincial, and local regulatory frameworks.
Kung sa kalagayan po ng small scale o yung mga maliit ang mga nagmimina dito sa Camarines Norte, talagang malala pa din ang paggamit ng asobi. Siyempre, yung traditional, yung kaisipan ng mga tao, ng mga minero, na yung pagkuha ng ginto, mas mabilis siya ang kunin kung gagamitan mo siya ng asobi.
Engagement of stakeholders really key for success of convention like Minamata Convention. And there is a particular need related to the SGM sector, and that is to involve indigenous peoples as well as local communities in the work. And that is both the development of the action plans for SGM, but also their implementation.
As a member or part of the applied tribe, the indigenous people in the Northern Philippines, everybody wants to be formalized or legalized in their operations.
Working honestly and closely with women, indigenous peoples, large-scale miners, and youth is very important.
Naniniwala ko na walang kahit anong programa na magsasucceed kung hindi siya gagamitan ng gender-based analysis. Yung partisipasyon ng kababaihan at kalalakihan ay ma-recognize yan.
Make Mercury history!
Planet Gold now is coming into the first phase of the countries. The first 8 countries that participated in the program are all finishing their child project as we speak. So to date, we can confidently measure that we have avoided 30 tons of mercury emitted to the environment with the 8 countries. We have trained about 17,000 miners directly and being formalized. And there is all the steps that are being put into the program so that this continues beyond the project lifetime.
We know the Minamata Convention, the Minamata National Action Plan will help us link the efforts of the local level to the national level, which will facilitate formalization and implementation.
And these action plans should, of course, not be documents to be put on shelf, but should build on the knowledge of miners, of indigenous peoples, of local communities, be adaptable, and also empower local governments really to find solutions that are suited for the specific circumstances.